Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and we'll be sharing some latest space updates with you. Starting with the test fire of the first upgraded Raptor engine, we'll then talk about Space Adventure dropping plans of tourist flight on Crew Dragon. Then we'll look into the possibility of carrying out an orbital flight test within 2021. We'll wrap up with a Chinese launch update. Let's get started with SpaceX test fires their first Raptor 2 Starship engine for the first time. Recently, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has announced that SpaceX has carried out the first test of Starship's new Raptor 2 engine. During the test, the Raptor 2 variant became the world's most powerful rocket engine with a huge amount of thrust. But unfortunately, the test ended with the Raptor destroying itself at last. In comparison to Raptor 1, Raptor 2's demise was quite earlier, as Raptor 1 had stood several tests. Other than SpaceX, Blue Origin is also working on making the most powerful engines. Their BE-4 engine, which is under development phase, was the most powerful methane and oxygen-run rocket engine ever tested. As known, Blue Origin has designed BE-4 to produce thrust of nearly 240 tons. But according to some recent updates, the SpaceX Raptor 2 version has produced more thrust than BE-4 during this very first static fire. According to Musk's tweet, it produced nearly 240 tons of thrust with chamber pressure at 321 bars. Though Raptor 2 has surpassed BE-4 in thrust, BE-4 still has a good position as it didn't explode during its full-fledged engine static fire. Raptor 2 reached a record level and got destroyed, but that's a beginning only, as the engine was designed to produce thrust only up to 230 tons during flight, and it produced more. That's good. Musk stated that Raptor 2 is a major improvement in simplification over Raptor 1, which technically has a thrust of 185 tons at 270 bar chamber pressure. These Raptor 2 engines will ultimately help Super Heavy Booster to reach the state to produce 50% more thrust than it produces initially. In 2020, SpaceX had successfully maxed Raptor 1 prototypes by a great deal without fail. Musk eventually stated that Raptor 1 had faced minimal damage, but reached the level 330 bar chamber pressure and kept above 320 bar pressure for nearly 10 seconds. Report says that if the Raptor 2 prototype had also reached 330 bar, it would have produced around 252 tons of thrust. Now we'll talk about Space Adventures, who drops plans of tourist flight on Crew Dragon. In early 2020, Space Adventures had publicized that they've signed a contract with SpaceX for a Crew Dragon flight. According to the contract, the spacecraft would carry 4 customers as crew to an orbit double higher than the space station. They would stay in orbit for 5 days and then return back to Earth. The mission was planned to be carried out in between late 2021 to mid-2022. Updates regarding progress of preparation of mission, customers, and probable launch dates were coming up. But Tom Shelley, president of Space Adventures, recently stated that they're no longer continuing the mission. He said, "Ultimately, our reservation with SpaceX expired, and that's not a mission that we're going to be executing in the immediate future." Stacy Tiern, a representative of Space Adventures, confirmed, "The mission was marketed to a large number of our prospective customers, but ultimately the mix of price, timing, and experience wasn't right at that particular time, and our contract with SpaceX expired. We hope to revisit the offering in the future." In mid-2021, Space Adventures announced that they had acquired a dedicated Soyuz flight to the space station. Report says that the Soyuz SM-20 spacecraft will launch on the 8th of December to the space station, carrying Japanese billionaire Yusaki Maezawa, Yozo Hirano, his production assistant, and Alexander Mazurkin, a professional astronaut, on board. In this mission, the spacecraft will spend about 12 days at the station and then will return back to Earth. Training of both Maezawa and Hirano has been going on in Russia. Report says that Space Adventures is also planning for a second mission to the station. This second mission will feature a spacewalk by one of the private astronauts. That mission is planned to launch in 2023, but till now, no names of customers have been announced for that mission. Our following update is based on the Starship orbital flight test, which has chances of being carried out next month, says Musk. We already know that the historic first orbital launch of Starship has been pushed back to the next year, 2022, due to delay in the procedure of license approval from the Federal Aviation Administration. But a couple of days before, SpaceX teams have successfully carried out the static fire test of ship SN20, which is showing some hopes of orbital launch within this year. Following the static fire test, Musk has tweeted about the probability of launching Starship in 2021. He wrote, "If all goes well, Starship will be ready for its first orbital launch attempt next month, pending regulatory approval." Static fire was the major step before going for the orbital test flight. Earlier it was stated that a static fire test will be done within a couple of months, but as the static fire has been done already, and that too in a successful way, thus they head for the orbital flight test. Musk had pointed out that the launch may become pending depending on the receipt of regulatory approval from the regulatory agency, FAA. The draft of environmental review on SpaceX's work at Texas, which FAA had released on the 17th of September, got mass attention. Though the portal for public comment was open until the 18th of October, yet report says that the agency will accept comments through the mail till the 1st of November. Report says that a good number of people have supported SpaceX's Starship project on one hand. On the other hand, many have raised their voices against environmental impact from massive launches like Starship. Today, we will end with an update on classified space debris mitigation technology satellite launched by China. Keeping the test of space debris reduction technologies as a goal, China launched the Shenzhen 21 satellite on the 23rd of October. Report says that at nearly 9:27 p.m. Eastern Time, the Shenzhen 21 satellite was launched aboard a Long March 3B rocket from the launch pad of Xichang Satellite Launch Center in southwest China. Nearly an hour after liftoff, the launch success was confirmed by the China Aerospace Science and Technology Corp, CASC. Sources state that this satellite was launched towards geosynchronous transfer orbit. According to some reports, Shenzhen 21 will be used to test and verify space debris mitigation technologies. With the completion of this launch, China nailed their 39th overall launch of the year. For China Aerospace Science and Technology Corp, this was the 36th launch of the year. And the report states the agency is aiming for launching more than 40 missions by the end of 2021. Regarding this present launch, China didn't disclose any launch details. The Shenzhen 21 satellite is meant to be a test vehicle for testing out space debris clearance technologies, but the secrecy and mission points towards satellite usage for both civilian and armed forces. Regarding this debris-removing technology, the Shanghai Academy of Spaceflight Technology had revealed a supplementary service spacecraft in the earlier month. A report says that the service spacecraft could dock and refuel another satellite as soon as it comes within 2 meters of the defunct satellite. This technology is the same as the mission extension vehicles made by different companies, such as Astroscale, Space Logistics, and DARPA, etc. Launch of Shiyan 10 was carried out earlier in late September this year, but the report says that the mission had a problem. The Shiyan 10 satellite had remained unresponsive on its propulsion control for the next couple of weeks from launch. Later, the satellite started working normally and it became active. According to a report, it was held that any anomaly with the launcher may have caused the problem, but now as we can see that Long March 3B has successfully delivered the Shenzhen 21 satellite, it became clear that the launcher vehicle had no issues. According to the U.S. Space Force's 18th Space Control Squadron, Shenzhen 10 is working properly and it continues to raise its orbit. Presently, it's risen to the perigee of 1,100 kilometers, with an apogee of 40,100 kilometers. As known, it will continue to rise till it reaches the geosynchronous transfer orbit. China had earlier launched a technology demonstration satellite, Shenzhen-17, in 2016 for practice servicing in orbit. The Secure World Foundation, which keeps an eye on all satellite operations, stated that the Chinese satellite had approached Zhangjing 5A, then Zhangjing 6B, and then Shenzhen 20. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.